There are some places in the world that are considered nerd mecca. This is one of those places. It's the Ghostbusters fire station. This is where they solve their ghost-related crimes and hauntings and things. There's the whole ectoplasm business. Can you imagine, like, just exploding out of the roof? Vast numbers of ghosts have been released by that stupid guy from the EPA. Curse you and your short beard! So as you can see, it's an actual, real, honest-to-goodness fire station now. It's hook and ladder 8. I know what the ladder's used for. Not quite sure about the hook. Maybe they catch giant fish that are made of fire. And now we're going to go on a bit of a tour and find some other Ghostbusters related landmarks, because essentially the movie is a homage to New York City as much as it is about people who fight ghosts. Here at the front of the New York Public Library. Now, you may recognize this from Ghostbusters. These are the famous lions that turn into the Keymaster and the Gatekeeper. They're serving the almighty Zool by joining together and releasing him from his confinement. I was just wondering, you know, just casually, just off the cuff, are you the Gatekeeper? The New York Public Library is actually a network of more than 85 libraries. This is the New York Library Center for Humanities. It was completed in 1911 after 14 years of construction at a cost of $29 million, which in 1911 was all the money in the world. No, seriously, you totally look like the Gatekeeper. Are you the Gatekeeper? And it's a center of 85 libraries, which are positioned around the five boroughs. So it's absolutely enormous. There are more than 11 million items you can borrow, of which only 7 million are Tintin books. This is the most frustrating interview I've ever done. This is also a famous example of the Beaux-Arts style of construction, which New York helped to make famous. Anyway, let's go to the next stop. This is our third and final destination on the Ghostbusters tour of New York. This is number 55 Central Park West, otherwise known as Dana Barrett's apartment. This thing is a freaking lightning rod for psychokinetic activity. The structure of this building is not actually made of the materials that they said in the film. It is in fact made of solid stone and steel. This is a great disappointment to me because I worship the great leader Zool and want him to return to Earth to take over. Unfortunately, it's not going to happen here. This is instead the doorway to Dove B. Goldstein, MD, Obstetrics and Gynecology. I live in the hope that you'll return one day, Zool. I will act in your service. Please, return. You may remember Rick Moranis leaping out the front door of this building, having been transformed into a dog. He runs into Central Park, which is just over there, and terrorizes some people in a restaurant. So I'm just having a party in my apartment. We're gonna have some snacks and dips and stuff. Just a bunch of people from work, you know, accountants and stuff like that. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been the Ghostbusters tour of New York.